Hooyah! This is Robin from the Back Pain Secret Podcast, and today we are going to talk about how to believe in yourself when you're suffering from sciatica. How to believe in yourself when you're suffering from sciatica. I'm going to play the intro song. I'll be right back, guys.
So, here's the important question. How can back pain sufferers like us, who don't want to use prescription drugs or go through surgery, heal our back pain? How do we live our daily lives in a way that allows us to go to work, take care of our families, enjoy life, and still manage our back pain? That is the question, and this podcast will give you the answer. My name is Robin Wakeham, and welcome to Back Pain Secrets.
Okay, guys, so I'm back, and today's topic is how to believe in yourself when you're suffering from sciatica. Just to give you a bit of an update about what I'm about, what I'm doing, you know, I've been on vacation, and I'm all fired up here for the new year. And I made a commitment to myself, you know, I'm going to do this podcast every day, okay? Every day, 7 days a week, first thing in the morning, okay? So it's five, almost 6 o'clock here in Sweden, and I'm going at it, okay? So I hope you guys will be checking in with me every day for the rest of the year, okay? If I'm not here, okay, doing this, I'm seriously ill, okay? So I'm really going to do this every day, 7 days a week. That's my commitment to you, okay? That's my New Year's resolution, okay? Okay, guys, so today we're going to talk about Tom, okay? And Tom is a made-up name, of course, to protect the innocent. Tom is 45 years old. He's married. He has two kids. He's currently in a bank job. He was in marketing before, but he's at the bank right now. And growing up, Tom was a very, very successful soccer player, okay? Soccer. So he didn't turn pro, but it was almost pro time, okay? He injured his back when he was about 16 or 17. He tried to rehab it and tried to do all this stuff, you know, to come back, but he had a herniated disc. That's actually when the disc cracks open, and that really irritated him, you know. So he couldn't really play soccer anymore. He was more or less, he had a little back pain all the time, but the worst thing now, the last few years, had been the sciatica pain in his left leg. Gone down to his back, buttocks, down his leg, down to his foot, okay? And it was constantly tingling, burning sensation in his back. And that was really, really irritating him, okay? So, growing up, like being a sports star and stuff, he felt really powerful, you know? He felt like he was on the top of the world, he could do anything. And the confidence that the sports was giving him was that he felt like he could tackle anything, you know, in the world. But when he couldn't do this anymore, you know, he started to lose confidence more and more in himself. He was also accustomed to work out every day, like a few hours, you know. That also gave him a lot of endorphins and stuff in his body, so he felt really strong. But year by year, you know, for the past 10, 15 years, gradually he just felt like he started to not believe in himself, you know, anymore, you know. And he was suffering, you know. He started to do the bare minimum. Instead of like going in and doing all kinds of stuff to really deliver, he did the bare minimum at job, at his work, at home, okay? And he also started to like work out less and less because he felt like he couldn't do the stuff he used to do when he was in his 20s, right? So he felt like ashamed almost, you know, he couldn't really run too much. He couldn't really do a lot of strength training because that created more pain for him, okay? And as I talked to him later on, he was doing the wrong thing, but anyway. So he felt more and more lazy. He was just working out once a week. He wasn't doing any walks at all. He wasn't standing up at work, you know, and he started to gain weight. But internally, guys, he really felt like he didn't believe in himself, and he felt like he didn't have enough energy. He wasn't, like, enough determined. And also he started to think about what other people would say about the stuff he was doing, you know. He just lost his vibe, you could say that, or his mojo. There's many different words for this, but he just felt like he wasn't able to do what he wanted to do and what he's supposed to do in the world, okay? So we had a chat about this, about his back pain. He got all the regular advice, you know, to walk every day 30 minutes, to stand up at the desk 30 minutes, three times a day, do some core stability exercises. He got some new exercises for the gym. But at the core, you could see that this man, Tom, he had this confidence problems, you know, and everyone all over the world has this different stages in their life, you know, and there's it's easy to it's important to work through it in order to move to the next level or get through this, you know. I've felt this as well, so like it's a common thing. So I was telling him, you know, you can have I have a few ideas, Tom, that you can actually use to reduce this, okay? First off, Tom, get momentum. Get momentum. And what do I mean with that, okay? It's so easy when you start to create a goal that or you want to achieve something that you have this big goal, but you need to have these small wins, okay? So focus on doing a little bit every day, okay? And that will actually increase the dopamine levels in your brain, okay? That will make you feel better. So, for example, for your job tomorrow, okay, what's the one thing you could do at work tomorrow to move forward, okay, to get that project done, to like start to come to completion, to feel good about yourself, okay? Also in your relationship, if you're married, if you're dating, whatever, you know, what is a small thing you can do to show appreciation? Like a kiss, a smile, something that will like enhance that relationship. For your health, Tom, I told him, you know, for Christ's sakes, Tom, go for a walk every day, okay? Stand up at work, okay? Maybe go to the gym 2 or 3 times a week, okay? And that will also, because when you're moving, that also increases momentum, and the dopamine creates that in the brain. You feel good about yourself, okay? And the thing is now, because New Year's Eve is coming up and everyone's had these big New Year's resolutions, don't go out and go all in one day and just crush that day and do everything perfect, and then you don't do anything else the other days, okay? That's not, you're just gonna be disappointed on in yourself, okay? So you need to do it a little thing every day and just keep on doing that, okay? Then number two, integration, okay? And what do I mean with integration? When something good happens to you, okay, Tom, and you're listening, you have to think about it and give yourself credit. Be proud of yourself, okay? Just don't go through the day and like cross off the checklist, tick, 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 tick. And then after like 5, 6, 10 years, you've gone all through all these checklists, but you haven't given yourself credit for, okay? So you have to sit down at the end of the day and say to yourself, you know, I did good today, you know, I did good. It's very important to make sure that you integrate the wins that you have in your life in your life, so that also builds your character, okay? And it builds strength, because if you think back of the stuff that happened during the day and the week and the month and the year, and once bad shit happens, okay, we know, like, we're all gonna have challenges in the future. You can look back at those days that you've crushed it and did something good, and that will give you strength, okay? So give yourself credit, man. Whoever you are, whoever you're listening, you know, give yourself credit for the wins you have in your life. Also, number three, get some feedback, okay? Most people fear to get feedback, okay? Especially if you're feeling like you're suffering from back pain and you have confidence problems and you're in a rut. You get very sensitive because you're afraid of any feedback you have that's negative. You're gonna take it like they might say you're ugly, that you're not good enough at what you do and stuff, you know. So that can really irritate you and make you scared, okay? But you should ask for feedback, okay? Ask just a question like this, like go to your friend or go to someone that you respect and say, "Hey, can I ask you a question, man? What am I doing right now? You know, how do you look at what I'm doing? You know, because at the moment I feel like I'm not really doing anything right, okay?" And it's strange, you know, but a lot of people that are high achievers and stuff, when they're very critical to them of themselves. They're like perfectionists. They're trying to do everything perfect. Or they might have grown up in an environment where the parents or some relative or some friends were very negative and critical to what they were doing, and they have this, they carry this shit around all their life, okay? So get some feedback, and if there it's negative feedback, first off think, you know, is this correct, you know, and ask another person that, and if you're getting a lot of negative feedback, just sit down and like go over what you're doing and change directions maybe, okay? But just because you get someone that says like you get some negative feedback, it might not be true, okay? You need to check that, okay? Okay, number four. Feel good in advance. And what the hell do I mean with that? To feel good in advance. Well, when you wake up, when you wake up, you want to feel good, right? You want to be happy, you want to be motivated, you want to be driven, you want to be passionate, okay? But sometimes you just wake up and you feel like shit, okay? And that's ordinary. It happens to everyone, okay? And there's a few techniques that you can get to feel better, even if you have a wake up and if you're in a bad mood and you feel bad, First off is to drink water, okay? Have a half a liter to a liter of water, okay? Go for a walk, okay? And then what I do also is to can like read out loud some in like texts that are very motivational, okay? My main guy is Anthony Robbins, okay? I love him. Whatever he's done, go online, read a few things from that, Big leaders, other big leaders like Martin Luther King, Napoleon Hill. If you're Christian or if you're religious, read from the Bible or any other holy book, And this, when you're reading stuff out loud, it actually activates the passion in you, okay? Especially if the text is passionate and motivational, okay? That's a little trick. Because it's important to everyone that's listening out there today, and for you too, as Tom, that you don't have energy and passion and happiness like from the get-go, okay? That's stuff that you create internally, okay? And you have to be able to deal with yourself and know yourself that well to have strategies that if you wake up and you feel like shit and you're not feeling like you want to do this stuff and you feel like it's gonna be a horrible day, you gotta switch that shit around, okay? And this is something that you can actually do, to do that. And number five, love, okay? Love, love, love. Make sure you notice the beautiful things that you are actually doing and contributing to the life. It could be like you're a good parent, okay? You're giving your kids a good start in life, okay? It could be that you're very, very attentive and listening to your wife or spouse or whatever, recognize that you're actually sending stuff out in the world and making it better, Because also, and if you feel like I feel sometimes, and I know a lot of my patients do sometimes as well, they feel like, well, I'm not really contributing with anything right now, okay? I'm not doing it, okay? Just think about this, that you are unique, my friend, okay? There's 7 billion people on Earth right now, and you are unique, okay? There's no one out there that is an exact copy of you, okay? So you need to say to yourself, that I'm meant to live my life in my unique way, and love the stuff that is strange about, the stuff that makes you weird and just live that full out, okay? And I may say to yourself, I'm made this way and honor that, okay? It's very, very important. And loving yourself, loving the process of getting better, okay? Love the stuff that's good about you, but also recognize that there is some stuff that you need to work on, okay? And don't put yourself down by that, okay? Just say, I need to work on a few things, and love that process, okay? On getting better on that, okay? So guys, there's a few things here to do that you can actually do. How to believe in yourself when you're suffering from back pain. And first we had momentum, right? You need to get moving, okay? And do a little bit every day. We had integration. When something good happens to you need to recognize that, think about that, and own that, and take that into your heart. Number three, get some feedback, okay? And if the feedback is good, that's great, But if you get bad feedback from many different people, then you might just sit down and reassess what you're doing and change it around, okay? Number four was feel good in advance, okay? So when you wake up and you might feel bad or something shitty happened, you need to do some stuff. Read out loud some positive text to switch that around. And also love, okay? Love. You need to love yourself, love the process of getting better, okay? That's all I had to today, and I'm gonna see you guys tomorrow. It's a new year tomorrow, okay? So I'm all fired up for that. I hope you have a great New Year's Eve, and I'll talk to you tomorrow. And guys, remember, just one step away from healing your back pain.
Want more back pain secrets? Then go ahead and get your free copy of my best-selling book, Back Pain Secrets, at backpainsecrets.com. Inside this book, you will find my top secrets to healing your back pain without prescription drugs or surgery that have helped thousands of other people just like you.